yeah, 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 yeah. When I step up in the place, say yo, I step correct. Got you all eject. I got that head nod shit that make you break your neck. Got you all eject. And you know we come through to wreck the discotheque. Got you all eject. Throw your hands up in the air, don't ever disrespect. Got you all eject. Bust the rhymes up in the place, true indeed. Yes, I can't reckon that's word on my feet. I'm guaranteed to give you what you need. One blood, everybody like Junior Reed. Wake up every morning, yo, I must succeed. Nationwide knockoffs make the world stampede. Yo, Willie, make we roll some weed. Mad charge, nigga, now I must proceed. Yo, we about to make moves, set speed. Beast who made me fight Q-tip, at least I need. Watch me knock you out like Apollo Creed. Body blows, busting your shit, making you bleed. Just feed off.
Okay, alright. Chill out, chill out. I'm trying to get an understanding, okay? Hold on, give me 1 second, alright? I'm just trying to wrap my mind around this situation right here. This shit's kind of heavy, okay? Alright, is it that obvious that mega preacher here in College Park, or aka Atlanta, Georgia, Creflo Dollar, got that much pull on y'all Negroes or the African American community, or should I say Christian community? Southern Christian community. So when he gives orders, y'all follow through, right? So it is painfully obvious that Creflo Dollar keeps y'all Negroes in check. Am I right? Or am I making that up? Am I making that up? And for those who don't know who I'm talking about, and those who don't know me, let me introduce myself. I go by Sony Legend, SLO1. For those who know me, I'm here today to talk about Creflo Dollar and his world changers and how they rejected Eddie Long's New Birth Community. here recently, Eddie Long, you know, about the scandal that was going on with the sexual situation, and had some church members that were filing civil suit on Eddie Long. And he settled out of court, you know. And this is the same brother, this is the same pastor that stated that, you know, he hasn't thrown a rock yet. He had several rocks in his arsenal, and he hasn't thrown not one. But yet and still, truth be told, he settled out of court. Okay? So here recently, Creflo Dollar had a sermon standing up for his brother preacher man, you know, because you got to keep... you know, the flock in line, you know. We got to keep that money flowing. Am I right? So he told his congregation, I think this was this past Sunday, that, you know, if your pastor gets in a wreck, you're not supposed to abandon him. And basically he was referring to the whole Eddie Long incident, you know. And Jesus paid the premium on his insurance. So Eddie Long got in a wreck. Jesus paid the premium on the insurance to bail him out. And I'm not going to go into all the details about what Creflo actually said. There's many people who have actually seen the video before the video was taken down here on YouTube recently. And I'm just, you know, all these things are starting to go through my mind. But the first thing that goes through my mind, the first, is we living in the Bible Belt, me being from Atlanta, Georgia. You know, this is a Civil War country where, you know, they flew the Confederate flag for a long time. It was the state flag for the state of Georgia. And it just dawned on me when I seen that, how Creflo Dollar just ordered these people not to come to his church, but to go back to Eddie Long's church. When I seen that, that let me know that the African American community, mentally and spiritually, has never left the plantation. Their mind is still in a slave state, worshiping a slave religion. Because that's what it is. That's what Christianity is. I hate to burst your bubble. I know it's a tradition that you've been carrying on year after year, generation after generation. Yes, I know. But you know, your great-great-grandparents that were slaves, that fought in the Civil War, you know, they didn't know no better. Slavery was all they knew. You know? Hell. So, when it was taken from their natural habitat, which was Africa, and brought here as slaves, Christianity was what everybody else was worshiping, right? So, you know, you just follow the leader. You didn't know no better. You didn't know nothing about your true culture or origins or history or have the education or access to the knowledge to get a full understanding of what your role and purpose is. So, you know, you, that's why you're the African American, right? And it's sad. It's really sad to see that because, you know, I'm just going to be the first to state this, that Christianity is no longer about spirituality. Christians are casting their spirituality in the name of Jesus capitalism a long time ago. You know, it's no true spirituality there. And it's painfully obvious with this joker, Eddie Long and Creflo Dollar. I mean, the gig is up. They don't want to talk about real issues. They don't want to talk about real events. You know, they want to keep it simple, stupid, you know, because that's what the whole congregation is stuck on. They stuck on stupid. They hit that Bible cap where they can't think anything beyond or outside the Bible. That's mind control. And from outside looking in, hey, it looks like a cult to me. You want to get on other people and their traditions, you know, and their cultures. But look at the word culture. The root word of culture is cult. And this looks more cult-like than anything. That's real. That's real. This is what y'all got to come to grips with. This is the reality that y'all got to look at, you know? Because you know what? Your legacy is on the line. And God forbid that your legacy's foundation, that is built off a lie. Don't let that be the case here. So, you know, you do have that denial there because you don't want to admit the truth. The truth is out about everything about your religion. You know, you tell me, wait for Jesus. A God's son is coming. But I look in the sky, I see God's son every day. You know, you go to church on Sunday to worship the sun, but you didn't know that, right? Because God's son, the sun in the sky, is the light of the world, not your Jesus. I mean, you don't see that. But you know, we had to keep it simple, stupid, because you couldn't relate to the science behind the sun giving life to this planet. Because if we talk about the power of the sun, that means we have to go into the science. We want to keep it simple and give you a man so you can worship, so you can have something to relate to. It's more simpler that way, right? You know? We don't want no science. Keep it simple. We dumb. We want salvation. We want this to be figured out. We got it under wraps. God is going to save us, which is Jesus. That's what you think. That's what you think. But that's an illusion that you created, right? It's painfully obvious. Y'all don't want the truth, B. Y'all don't want the truth. The science is there. Y'all not going to get away from science. See, science is the church's enemy. If y'all don't realize that by now, science is the church's enemy. But you know what? Niggas love technology, but they hate the science that brought them to technology. That's pretty narrow-minded, right? That's pretty narrow-minded, but that's what it is, you know. I don't know what to say on that one. This one's kind of major right here. This is for the record books, you know. And you know, this is coming from the same group of people that voted for Obama. These were the same niggas that was on Obama's dick, ain't that right?
Afro angel, tie my weapons and tangles, black star spangle, fragile like hematite, with the east oils I write, despite the lack of sunlight, got my battle boots tight, now that the government's gone, can't tell your left from your right, winged assassins laughing while the new world's collapsing, mother earth's ribs crashed in, armored carries I'm blasting, as the earth rebels, my womb swells, the birth of black magic, saving my people, force of habit, you can't find it if you ain't never had it, spiritually crafted, blacklisted, hair twisted, ghetto embargo lifted, power shifting, comb fisted, I predict goddesses, you running after witches, I kiss my 14 stitches. Keep all my baby girl wishes. I predict all the oceans turn dry. Not one baby girl will cry as you attempt to grow broccoli from the desert. We will take our pregnant bodies, drink from underground rivers, wash your face between our legs. While recreating humanity, we will summon Yemaya, search for our fertility, ban all pink and yellow pills, ban all pink and yellow pills. I predict killing fields of ghetto arm patch, anti-hatch, hate groups will be bombed. Childbirth becomes outlaw, always will be branded, numbered, and law. Our paper money is gone. Confused scholars can interpret our scrolls. Your sky has holes. We know the young is old. Nostradamus tell us how the story gets told. So
as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, we got some real issues that's going on right about now. And your pastor's scared to even talk about them. Or maybe correction. How about this? How about Creflo is just in the pocket to keep y'all Negroes not only in line, but tamed and domesticated and divided and conquered? That's what that is. Because if you're not talking about the New World Order right now, then you're really not talking about shit. Okay? The executive orders still stand. And you may ask me, what executive orders? What are you talking about? You know, okay, so for anybody who asks me that, especially if you're older than me, okay? Especially if you're older than me, you're going to ask me what executive orders. I'm going to look at you like, okay, now, bro, how long have you been getting money? How old are you? How long have you been getting money? You don't know what executive orders I'm talking about. You don't know what executive orders I'm talking about. Okay, so what you're saying, you need a visual aid? You need some help? You need some help trying to grasp what's going on? Okay, no problem. I could do that. Let me help you out right quick, okay? This one's on me.
Better yet, speaking of writing on the wall, the writing is on your money. Forget writing on the wall. It's on your money. You know what I'm saying?
In the meantime, do what you do. By any means necessary, you get that fucking paper, nigga. All day. It's SL01. And matter of fact, here's one for the road, baby. Count that one. Now you up on the board, that's one up, my man. One up. That's all you right there. I'll go ahead and let you get that. Go ahead, take that. Yeah. See, that one right there, that was on me right there, you know? Get them out of here. Get these folks up out of here, bruh. Get these suckers out of here. Check this out, okay? I'm just going to go ahead and state this one last time, all right? Religion is for suckers. Because if you're truly a spiritual person, you cannot be confined by the boundaries of religion. The spirit is free and will forever be free. Okay? So keep thinking you're free. Keep thinking you're brave. Okay? Keep thinking that you're ready for what's in store. Okay? Because I'm going to be serious with y'all people. Okay? All right. What is the root word to civilization? Okay? The root word of civilization is civil. And from civil, you get the word civilian, which is you. And since the civilian fails to have a militant mind, it will forever be dependent on the military for protection. And as you can see and look around you, we know that the military, without a doubt, does not have your interest in mind. Okay? So keep playing your game and keep doing what you do, and we're going to see how things turn out. Okay? I'll see y'all niggas on the other side. We out. One.
Caliber unknown, infinite in stature, indiscriminate fracture, syndicated rapture, indicated capture, syncopated nature, defeated we raised the wager, no secret I hate the majors, but they major players, so I'm gladiating, not so gladly waiting, niggas is graduating, fuck what flag we waving, kids is misbehaving, parents is worse than Satan, apparently church is pagan, sworn to win my freedom through words that sing my freedom, rebirth the world of earth and intend to spend my freedom, prepared to defend the nexus, didn't get in for no lexus, didn't get on for connection, or to get off my erection, fuck the soft and the wetness, luck is lost on election, bucket the cost of detection, sent to a boss of direction, still too much to achieve, reveal too much to believe, feel too much to receive, appear before you achieve.